performance socket trench, as we already demonstrated by my stallion here. So ball sits in the socket, it's got this lovely range of motion, not quite as much as the shoulder because it's a deeper socket. But as runners, because we only move in a forward to backwards direction, we tend to get a loss of rotational mobility in our hip. You might think to yourself, why do I need that? Why am I going in that direction? It's crucial for ensuring that all the muscles that sit around that area are used within their scope of movement. Okay? If you've got a tight muscle in one direction, it limits its power, it limits its strength, it limits its movement, and it leads to a risk of injury. Basically, I'm going to tell you now about hip capture. We're going to go a bit off into anatomy so that you can all understand what's happening in your hip joints and why we want to mobilize them. Okay? Ready for this? Am I paying attention? So, the capsule of a joint is the soft tissue that sits around the two bones and holds the two together. Okay, on my skelly, it's represented by a screw. Okay. You don't have those, I hope. Okay, they do get in the way when you're trying to do movies. So, the capsule that sits around here is basically an extension of the same sort of tissue as muscle. Okay, it's elastic, it moves around. It determines the amount of movement you've got. How many of you guys sit at a desk all day at work? Everyone, okay? So what we find with people that sit all day is that you tend to be quite short through the front. Your hip flexors short, okay? We touched on that last time. Short, tight hip flexors, impaired posture. You don't want to get impaired posture, it's harder running, makes me work harder, okay? So what happens to the joint if that muscle is short? Is that because the muscle attaches in here, it actually pulls this ball towards the front of the socket, okay? Now logically, you would think that that would mean the back of the capsule would be stretched, it would be loose. That's not how human bodies work, otherwise my job would be super simple, okay? What actually happens is the back of the capsule here tightens. So if you picture really sticky, thick goo in a nice mixing bowl, okay? This is your mixing bowl, your capsule is your sticky goo, your leg bone is your wooden spoon, okay? So if your wooden spoon is only working through one part of your mixing bowl, that sticky goo material is still sticking at the back of that joint, back of that bowl, it's not being moved. That's what happens back here. It starts to thicken and it starts to tighten, and then eventually, it's just too much work to get that bone and that wooden spoon to go into that part of the bowl, so you just stop bothering, okay? At that point, you can move forwards, but you've lost the ability to move backwards, okay? This bone should roll and glide within the socket. Often, we keep the roll, so you can twist around, but you lose the ability for it to glide backwards. That causes impingement of the structures of the front. So you're rolling on one spot. So if you think about your tires and you're trying to do reverse parallel, so we do a lot of those in Cheltenham. If you're reefing on the steering wheel without the tires moving, you're going to burn through one bit of tire way quicker than if you've got the whole thing gliding as you do that movement. Everybody get me? Okay. So if you're really tight in the back here, this is going to get quite sore. This is going to get pinched at the front. You're going to wear through the cartilage, which is what lines those two bones, much quicker at the area where you've got movement. It means, positive point, you're saving this bit. But in later life, we generally don't move back into the posterior capsule, so we really should probably use that bit first. Okay? So, if you've lost your ball and socket motion, if you're stuck at the front, you're not getting that hip back behind you, it's really hard to fire through your glutes and through your hamstrings, which is what gives you that propulsive force forward and makes that running far easier, okay? So we've chatted with you guys so far about the posture of running, that we want you up nice and tall, we want you thinking about your center of gravity in the middle of you, we've talked about keeping those muscles nice and long so that they work in a good system front to back. Now we're touching on the joints and how you guys keep those nice and long.